Welcome to Andrea Fit. I'm Andrea and this is your beach body workout number 4. So we're just gonna do another body weight workout and cardio and trigger every single part of your body. So let's get ready and start. We're starting with the touch and lift left side. So what you want to do is just touch the floor and then lift your knee as high as you can. But if you cannot touch the floor, it's okay, you don't have to. Just make sure your knee stays on top of your heel. So now we want to change side and do exactly the same. Remember, you want to keep your chest up all the time. And you want to inhale and exhale while you go down and keep your abdominals tight and push super hard. Next exercise is called tap and lift. So start with the right leg. This is a great balance exercise. It really works on your glutes, on your thighs, on your balance, on that core. Just feels amazing. Same thing to the other side. Now, see how I'm lifting my arms up? This is so we keep that energy levels up. We lift our heart rate to burn the calories and feel the push. Knee tucks, you want to bring the right knee to the left elbow, making sure that you're not arching your spine. You want to feel that your abdominals are really tight and your whole body is in the right position. And just exhale and inhale. It's a great cardio move while we tone at the same time. And now we want to do 10 that lift and lunge back. This is a great exercise to work on our hamstrings, our glutes, our thighs, our core. I personally love doing this every week and I recommend you to just keep doing and trying. And then if you get more advanced, you can add some little weight on it. Next exercise is absolutely one of my favorites, is the ballerina squat with leg lifts. So you want to open your legs wider than your hips and go down as low as you can, keeping your chest up. And then when you come up, tighten your glutes, lift your leg as high as you can. I love this exercise because you can really feel your inner thighs working. That bum and that tum, everything is working here. Also, you want to push it as hard. You want to always try to move on. Don't stop. Don't take a break. If you need to slow down, you can slow down, but keep the flow going. I love this move. I call it the pendulum, and you want to do 20. This is great for your legs and your balance again. It's a great cardio exercise, so just push it again. Stretch, squat, and jump. This is an intense exercise, so if you don't want to jump, what you can do is do 2 squats. It's a great one. I like the stretching part, stretch your hamstrings. It's like a little break in between. And then the squat course, works on your glutes and your thighs. And then the jump, it's an intense cardio move that I really enjoy. Now, we're doing the two-point plank. So you want to bring the left foot to your right hand and then change. And this is an awesome plank because it works your obliques and the whole entire transverse abdominals. And also it challenges your upper body. I call this exercise the high push-up. It's really good to work your shoulders and your back muscles. You want to keep that back straight, and all you want to do is push down, same as a push-up, taking your head in direction to the floor. Now, jump plank and ninja kick. You want to start in a plank position and from there just jump back and jump forward, opening your legs, shoulder width apart. And then for the ninja kick, you're going to put your hands like if you're going to do a headstand. And then what you do is you kick back. Really important here to not drop your head to the floor and just make sure that you don't lift your legs too high. So here we have an easier variation if you don't feel comfortable jumping, where you can start to feel some strength before you try the other one. And our last exercise is a side plank hip drop with hugs. So just from the side plank, you drop your hips and then you do 5 hugs, exhaling on the way down, controlling your hips and your back. This is a great oblique exercise and it really, really burns those obliques. But you want to make sure that you keep your hand under your shoulder and that you're in the proper position. Because if not, you can hurt yourself and we want to avoid that. And here an easier variation for that exercise again. You can always start building strength with these variations before you do the advanced.